it was obvious that the painting needed some treatment. The varnish had become darkened, the painting had lost some of its brilliance, and the colour wasn't easily legible. We carried out a temporary kind of exercise about 10 years ago, and at that stage it was also indicated that the canvas itself was becoming frayed. This is a canvas that's 150 years old, very large canvas, so you can imagine there's a lot of stress along the top of the canvas hanging off the tacks, and that at some stage we would have to take the painting down and reline it and re-strengthen the canvas and then put it back together again.
The issue always was that we were never able to get to the back of the painting to look at the support and to look at the structure, and that was always our main concerns with the work. We only ever had access to the front, and sometimes to fix a painting we of course need access to the back. So with the refurbishment of this part of the gallery, it gave us the opportunity to remove the painting from the wall and start the restoration work that we are now doing. The process of deinstalling the work was a really big undertaking, and this project has really had to be divided into so many different sections because everything to do with this painting is a huge undertaking. During that time, I mean, there was huge concerns that the painting would come away from the stretcher, that maybe the canvas was embrittled or oxidized and was very fragile, so it would not have the structural stability to stay in place. So throughout the entire moving process, lots of different measures were taken that were, I suppose you could call them, preventive conservation measures to make sure that the work was secured during transit.
Literally, we deinstalled the painting from the wall, we rotated the painting, and so we were able to see the back of the painting. And immediately we realized that there was a lot of work to do actually before removing the painting from the stretcher and doing the actual rolling of the painting. So we worked with the painting vertical on the back and all around edges for a few weeks in terms of consolidating the paint layer, consolidating the canvas, and then eventually we need to protect the front of the painting.
All of the painting was secured with a type of Japanese tissue. We call it a facing tissue that's applied to the painting in different strips with a light adhesive, usually an animal glue or a synthetic glue. In this case we used a synthetic glue, and really it works as a plaster or a band-aid on the surface that secures the paint in place so we can turn it and roll it onto the roller.
It's always a stressful operation for the painting to be rolled, but if it is done in the right way, it's not dangerous at all. But we made it as big as possible in order to go through the doors. So it's about 1 meter in diameter, which means that the painting has been, you know, there is only one spin and a half of the painting, which is not too much considering that it's nearly 6 meters long.
Once it was on the roller, which was on an A-frame with wheels, we were able to move it through the rest of the galleries. To the Millennium Wing, where then it had to go on a large crane and be cranked up onto the second floor because it was too big to go up through the stairwell. So this is what I mean when everything to do with this painting is a huge undertaking.